What's up, my dudes? It's your homeboy Max from Whipped Cream Media back at it again for another in-depth guide. So today we'll be talking about the skill rotations for all the warrior subclasses, namely the Gladiator, Moon Lord, Barbarian, and Destroyer. Before we start, I'd like to drop some quick shoutouts to these awesome people that have been very, very supportive, starting with our Lunaria fam. We've got Sin of Greed, Hexa, Arto, Azria, and Peach from Hunter's PH, Harmony from Guardians, Jedi 007, Lady Slayer, Drashiel, Cashmark, and Jay-Z from Lockdown, Thorpak Shakur from Prime, much love from you guys over there, Carpe Diem from Lucky Nanai, Mr. Iggy, and a special mention to Elfie Cute from our beloved Christelle. Aba aba, lumalande mga chong. Of course, shoutouts to our brothers from other servers as well. We've got Wavs from the guild MNL48, from Lindsay, and Cryola from Cassius III. Now, you may be wondering, but Max, you made the Sorceress Guide first. What happened to the hashtag SorcLife? Unfortunately, my Sorceress is under the same account as my Sniper, so I couldn't level it up as fast. I was more focused on the Warrior because the Gladiator is so damn addictive. It's not the best PvP class, but it really reminds you of the finger snapping spree back in the good old DNPC days. Speaking of gladiators, let's talk about the first subclass on the list. Now, gladiators aren't really that popular due to their low board damage and absolute melee range. What drove me to pick up the Gladiator is, simply put, it's really fun and non-linear to use. There's so many ways to play a Gladiator that every move feels like you're dancing around the fight with such grace. There will come a point where people will appreciate low cooldowns more than higher board damage, especially in PvP. So just a quick disclaimer, these rotations are more suitable in PvE as PvP rotations depend on the situation. Each class has a role in nests, and I believe that no class is totally weak in PvE. Always start your combos with triple slash for that nice defense debuff and follow it up with rising slash. Cast finishing attack, and as soon as the last damage tick applies, cast heavy slash to get your triple attack going. End the combo with a nice finishing attack for a solid 2204% board damage. Note that this is still the raw damage, and I didn't even include the defense debuff calculation from both triple slash and finishing attack, as well as the bonus 1000 plus attack buff from rising slash. Now that's some serious damage for an underrated class. Next is, of course, the popular Moon Lord. Now, this class basically deals the most damage out of all the subclasses due to the fact that Moon Lords have two skills with Diffusion. Pair that up with a pretty decent board damage and you'll have a warrior class that's well-rounded in both PvP and PvE. Start the combo by casting Present Cleave, followed up by Cyclone Slash. Once you reach the second swing, cast Moonblade Dance, directly followed up by Moonlight Splitter. Now don't cast Moonblade Dance yet and jump directly to Flash Dance with a Cyclone Swing follow-up, and finally end the combo with Moonblade Dance for a total of 2,884% board damage. Moving on to the next class, which is basically the axe counterpart of the Gladiator, the Barbarian. This class is one of the few that can execute a full 6-chain skill rotation without breaking a sweat. Unfortunately, this is compensated by low board damage and can often fail if you don't execute it fast. It will take some time to practice, but it will definitely be worth your time as soon as you master it.
Cut! Suck it back!
Open up with soccer kick combo for that nice defense debuff, and then with a circle swing. Cast Whirlwind immediately while waiting for Demolition Fist's cooldown. As soon as it's back, cast it immediately followed by another soccer kick combo for that debuff refresh, a stomp with circle swing, and end it with a circle break plus Whirlwind combo for a total of 2,558% damage. These numbers are pretty damn dope for a PvP class, don't you agree? Last on the list is Legendia's very own Demolition Man, the Destroyer. So this class is basically the Axe counterpart of the Moon Lord, as they are pretty damn versatile in all situations. Super armor, check. Defense debuff, check. Attack debuff, of course. Now, they might not be the best when it comes to finesse, but hey, since when was demolishing things beautiful? Alright? After casting Maelstrom Howl for that debuff, cast Ring Bombs and chain it with Rolling Attack followed up by Boomerang Crush. Cast Punishing Swing again, but wait for Maelstrom Howl to go off cooldown. Cast it right away for the defense debuff and use Boomerang Crush, and then end it with a Rolling Attack for a total of 2,106% damage. They may not be the best in the damage department, but Destroyers excel at sticking to the enemy's face and soaking in a lot of damage without flinching due to having a lot of super armor under the defense roll. They also draw the most threat out of all the subclasses. Before we end this video, here's a summary of all warrior subclasses with their pros and cons. So, gladiators are usually mistaken for being a duelist class only. When a gladiator is used correctly, they are very, very useful in a raid party if they are equipped with mastery accessories due to their defense debuffs. They might not be the best in terms of damage or normal skills, but once you've activated your chain skills, you and your party will definitely have a good time. Moon Lords are the strongest when it comes to dealing raw damage, but suffers from a lack of party-oriented skills. They are at their best when not being targeted by the monster or the boss. In terms of PvP, they excel in teamfights and guild wars. Barbarians suffer the same general insight as gladiators, but actually deal a lot of raw damage. They are blessed with fast skill animations, and with enough practice, you'll be executing those 6 chain skill combos like a breeze. The Destroyer is unique in that it's the only subclass that naturally excels in the defense role. The additional effects from their skills like super armor and additional threat has great chemistry with a lot of defense role skills. That's basically it for this video, so if you guys learned something, please let me know down in the comments. Also, I'd like to promote this new channel that I discovered, and boy oh boy, Ayato uses the Gladiator with such great finesse that it's mesmerizing to watch his or her PvP plays. Please do check out this channel and show some support by subscribing as well. I'll be promoting more and more startup channels in the following videos because honestly, I want to share the love that our subscribers have given us. In this time of crisis, let's not forget that as humans, we should be there for each other. So we hope you guys are staying safe in your homes right now. Peace, be nice, and we'll see you next time.